everybody. This is Sean Ross, Select Music, and today I want to talk about this record right here. This is the Toshio Matsuura Group, Six Scenes from the Dance Floor, released on Brownswood Recordings. This was a record that was kind of off my radar for a little while. Back at the beginning of the year, I got a chance to DJ with Toshio Matsuura himself. I'll actually show this off. I've got his signature. He signed the record for me at the end of the night, and he was completely wasted when he signed that. But shout outs to Toshio Matsuura because he's a super nice dude and a fantastic DJ. And Toshio Matsuura is a bit of a legend in Japan. He's mostly known as a DJ now, but he had a project called United Future Orchestra that he used to be a part of in one way or another. I'm not entirely sure. And with that, he sort of, I guess, moved on to this project right here, the Toshio Matsuura Group. And honestly, before I knew anything about this record, I sort of approached it with a little bit of hesitation. Not any time that I see that a track list of an album is littered mostly with covers. It can be a little bit exciting, but it can also be kind of scary at the same time, because it could end up being that it's more of a novelty record than it is an actually good listen. So, is Toshio Matsuura Group Six Scenes from the Dance Floor a novelty record? Or is it actually a solid record, and does it come recommended from me? I think a lot of my hesitation for picking up this album actually stemmed from the 12-inch single. Because the 12-inch single, the one thing that it's riding high off of is yet another cover of I Am the Black Gold of the Sun. Now, if you're unfamiliar with I Am the Black Gold of the Sun, it is a Minnie Riperton Rotary Club classic psychedelic soul funk track. And if you've never heard it, you really need to go check it out. And it had already been covered by Little Louis Vega. There we go. Almost got the two mixed up, but I managed to bring it back in the end. Anyways, Little Louis Vega had already covered that track for his New Yorkian Soul album. And even I felt like, and this is probably going to be a little bit blasphemous for anybody who really likes that New Yorkian Soul album, I'm not really that big of a fan of it, to be honest. That cover was already a watered-down version of I'm the Black Gold of the Sun, and I felt like, well, with this version from the Toshio Matsuura Group, honestly, what I would probably do is just even water it down even further. And after having listened to it, I will say that on a vocal end of the spectrum, the song is not great. The vocalist can't hold a candle to Minnie Riperton's vocals, and there are just some parts of it that she sort of goes off into her own bizarre vocal territory. It's like, what happened? Why? No, stop. Don't do that. But it doesn't completely ruin the song, because while the cover itself starts off as being pretty stock, it eventually detours into some territory where it actually almost takes on this Latin jazz sort of interpretation of this classic song. And I think that's actually a really good example of how this record is actually a lot better than I anticipated. In terms of looking at the track list on here, at least from the songs that I recognized, they all felt like they would be pretty stock, pretty standard, not really doing anything with the material that they were given. And yet, what they end up doing is giving you the basis, the foundation of the original song, and then putting a unique spin on it that actually makes these covers worth listening to. Ultimately, I was really surprised by the quality of the covers on here. What I was expecting was some really watered down, new jazzy, coffee house, boring ass background music. And what I got were actually some really involving, engaging, surprising, and actually like technically accomplished covers of some mostly electronic music tracks. The app cover of Carl Craig's Atlas is exactly what I think a live band jazz cover of an ambient techno song would sound like. And I'd say it's probably the closest to the source material in terms of not really going in any super crazy directions on it. But it's still sonically different enough from the original track that it doesn't, one, it never will negate the original, but it also makes it its own unique thing at the same time too. Brown Paper Bag is another example. The Ronnie Size and Represent drum and bass classic. I love that track. And it always had a bit of a live element to it with that iconic bass line and that screaming, that was an obnoxious sample, and some of the skitteriest drums you will ever hear. And they do it absolutely perfectly on this album. And while maybe that song could have taken a few more little change-ups to make it a little less straightforward, it's still really cool to hear a live band cover of Brown Paper Bag. But I will say, the true moment of genius of this record comes in the form of the last track, Do the Astro Plane, which really starts off like exactly where you would expect a live band cover of the Flying Lotus classic. Hits with the 4-4, it's got some really nice jazzy piano on it, and then about halfway, it breaks down and turns into this absolutely musical orgasm of like a spiritual jazz breakdown. And it comes completely out of left field because you think the groove is going to run throughout the entire track. And it's moments like that on this record that take what probably would have just been an okay to solid collection of covers to, wow, this is actually one of the most exciting, interesting, and goddammit, one of the most fun records I've listened to this year. Now, the other tracks on here that I'm less familiar with all still range from good to excellent. Kitty Bay, which is apparently some like 1974 proto acid jazz kind of track. And actually, it was this track alone that really got me excited to listen to the full album. So definitely, it's a great little up-tempo jazz, synth-led jazz track that's got some absolutely phenomenal funky drumming on it. And then going back to the album itself, or at least the vinyl rather, changes a good album opener. It really sets the mood quite well. It takes a little bit longer to get going than I would like, but once the groove sort of presents itself and all the musical elements sort of settle in, it actually makes for a nice little mood piece to get things started. High Noon, I think, is probably like the weakest track on the album just because it doesn't seem like it really goes anywhere. It's got sort of this weird Western slash Indian sort of vibe to it that just doesn't, it's just not, for as long as the track is, it's not that interesting. It's not terrible. And again, it sort of sets, it's a nice little mood piece in the middle of the album, but it's not a particularly memorable track by any stretch of the imagination. And LM2 is actually, the whole second half of this album is phenomenal. LM2 starts off as a nice little drum and bassy sort of track with some really fast syncopated drums, a solid guitar and bass line before it goes into this beautiful little breakdown and again catches you off guard and ends up going in a direction that you don't particularly may not have seen coming. At least I didn't see it coming. And it's that sort of unexpected aspect of this record that makes it such a joy to listen to. I think I've alluded to this a little bit already, but I have to talk about the quality of the musicianship on here. Everyone who plays on this record is top-notch. And I think, ultimately, aside from the fact that the songs themselves sounded really well done and had some unexpected twists to them that really helped them, these tracks differentiate themselves from the original source material, it's just the fact that, like, everyone on this record is a top-tier musician, and they all play much more skillfully than I ever would have imagined on this record. I was really going into this project thinking that I was going to hear some basic, watered-down, not even close to the same caliber as some real jazz musicians. And that is not the case on here. There is some really top-notch playing on here, especially in the drums, and since that's usually the part that I end up focusing on when it comes to music like this. I gotta say, the drummers that they put on here, one is Yusef Davies from Yusef Kamal, and the other guy, Tom Skinner, whose name for some reason sounds really familiar, but I can't really place what project he's a part of. He does a fantastic job on here. And so do all the other musicians on here. I would say that the weakest element of this record are some of the vocal tracks. Again, going back to the I'm the Black Gold of the Sun is pretty weak. And the, scat opening to do the astral plane. It's not great. It fits with the original, and I know why it's there. It just doesn't feel like it really adds anything to the track. It's not a deal breaker, because honest to God, I love that Do the Astral Plane track, and it's probably going to end up in my top 20 favorite songs of 2018. And so is this record. I'm honest to God surprised how much I really like this. The one thing that sort of makes me a little bit nervous is I don't know down the line how much I'm going to be listening to this record. For now, I absolutely love it and can't recommend it enough. If I were to give it a attach a score to it, probably a high 7 to a solid 8. Definitely recommend that anyone who likes modern jazz and is a fan of dance music, if you haven't checked this out, absolutely go and grab this record. Maybe get the digital copy, because if you want the extra tracks, although I wouldn't say that the I Am the Black Gold of the Sun really does anything for the record, and even if you were to skip that track, it's not really that big of a deal. Kitty Bay is worth it. Worth it, though. So, Toshio Matsuura Group, 6 scenes from the dance floor, 8 scenes from the dance floor, depending on which copy of this album you picked up. This has honestly been one of the biggest and nicest surprises of 2018 for me. This is a record that I went into with pretty reasonably low expectations and actually ended up coming out quite surprised. And I wouldn't be surprised if it ends up making its way onto my favorite records of 2018. But if you've given Toshio Matsuura Group 6-8 scenes from the dance floor a listen, let me know what you thought about it down in the comments. As always, go into the description, because that's where I will have musical links so you can check out this record for yourself. And yeah, that's going to be pretty much it for me today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video, hopefully, which will be next week. So until next time, guys, peace out.